trees of green, red roses too. I see them bloom for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. I see skies of blue and clouds of white, the bright blessed day, the dark sacred night, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. The colors of the rainbow, so pretty in the sky, are also on the faces of people going by. I see friends shaking hands, saying, how do you do? They're really saying, I love you. I hear babies cry. Much more than I ever knew, and I think to myself, what a wonderful world. Yes, I think to myself, what a wonderful.
Hey, all right, and the microphone is working, and it's another beautiful day here in paradise. I'm Rama P. Jama, and hey, I'm not working alone this morning. I'll let you know who's with me in just a minute. First, I want to tell you that you're tuned to Monterey Almost Live, ampmedia.org, streaming around the world, and cable channel 24 if you're lucky enough to live here in Monterey County. And hey, if you can watch the show, you're getting part of it anyway. So sit back and enjoy. We've got another hour of commercial-free music. Another hour of commercial-free music. And, you know, I like to say we're not like those other stations that give you an hour of request-driven music that when they're on lunch hour and they say they're out to lunch. I'm always out to lunch, and always request-driven. If you've got a request, you can send it to MontereyAlmostLive@yahoo.com. That's what my guest did today. He's been challenging my keyboard prowess, which is one finger at a time, and like that. So that's the request line right there. And yes, I do have a guest in the studio. It is Joe Braun Jr. Yeah, yeah. I'm introducing you as Joe Braun Jr. Just put the camera on me when I'm talking, okay? Just in case I have your dad on sometime. So, hey, good morning, Joe.
Good morning. How you doing,
Mama? I'm doing good. Thank you for watching and listening. And I met Joe at the West End celebration, and found out that he's one of the instructors at Guitars Not Guns, and found out that he watched my show. That was just blew me away. I said, hey, I don't think we've met. I'm Rama P. He said, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday, 8 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. At that point, I had to get off my knees and thank you, Lord. Anyway, it is another beautiful day here in paradise. Happy to be alive and well. And Joe is a musician, as you might imagine from the fact that that he is an instructor with Guitars Not Guns, and he's going to play some music for us. He's also a good friend for many decades of Big Joe Shelton, who was nominated for the 2012 Blues Song of the Year by the Blues Foundation. And they're an organization not too unlike Guitars Not Guns. They are there to preserve blues music, to support blues education, and what's that other one? To celebrate. That's where they give their awards and whatnot. And Big Joe was up for the Blues Song of the Year for 2012.
He was. It was his title song from his CD, which I happen to have.
All right.
The older I get, the better I was.
Ain't that the truth?
And so I was doing some consulting down in Fort Worth, and he said, why don't you come to Memphis too? And so ahead of my trip to Fort Worth, I went to Memphis and had a chance to go to the awards dinner. It was quite a ceremony.
Great
celebration.
Yeah. And I happen to know that you have a web page which documents that trip, and that's quite interesting, and even mentions the crossroads that Robert Johnson went to. So you didn't make any deals while you were back there, did you, Joe?
No, but hey. I did cross over the crossroads and went to a music festival near there that Big Joe did the day after the Blues Music Foundation ceremonies.
Fantastic. Well, listen, we're going to get into the music, and when we come back, we're going to have some music performed by Joe. Not big. Well, we're gonna have a set of Big Joe Shelton. Then we're gonna have some music performed by Joe Braun Jr. And we'll talk more about his trip back there, and also about Guitars Not Guns. So you're tuned to Monterey Almost Live, ampmedia.org. If you want to see what we played today, you want to see other things by Big Joe Shelton or other things that are on the internet that have been put up there by the people that put up the ones that I put in the playlist today, go to youtube.com/allthingscreative and check it out. Full disclosure. Okay. So you're tuned to Monterey Almost Live, ampmedia.org, and we're going to go right into some Big Joe Shelton. Yeah, I got all the mics up, and hey, there we go.
Everybody
Big Joe Shelton and the Black Prairie Blues Band. Here he is with the Blues Ambassadors. Big Joe Shelton, our featured artist for the first set. Yeah. Monterey Almost Live, Big Joe Shelton. Yeah, Big Joe Shelton. Here's the song that that was nominated for Blues Song of the Year by the Blues Foundation. I know it's coming up. I know it is. There it is. That was quick. What did? Who's the cameraman on that? That's what I want to. I got the mics up. Okay. Joe, you're lucky I got the mics up, first of all. You're that video ended a little quickly there. Even for me who was anticipating it, and camera on me when I'm talking, please, camera on me. Even for me who was anticipating it, and when I put it in the playlist, I realized it was only 1 minute and 5 seconds long. I don't think it was the full song, but it was probably until they arrested the person with the with their phone up in the air and the line. Oh, wait a minute.
That would have been what?
That was you.
That was you. My camera work.
Big Joe Felton's good friend and old school chum, too, huh? You guys went to graduate school together in, Illinois? Is that?
That's right.
Did I pronounce that right, Illinois?
Well, some people say it like that.
But I know there are those Illinois, those are the land of Lincoln elitists. Land of Lincoln, see? You can tell I hitchhiked through the state one time, up through Decatur. Decatur, do you remember me? Okay, that's the truth.
That's where I wound up when I first left here.
Really?
I was in Decatur, Illinois.
I thought you looked familiar.
And that was 1969. Everybody was coming this way, and I was going the other way.
Yeah, actually, pretty darn close. I think it was 66 for me, yeah. 66 or 67. Hitchhiked out there, yeah. So that's your good friend, Big Joe Shelton.
Right, we met in DeKalb.
Yeah, and you followed his career and been a part of a good friend of his through many decades now.
Many decades some real upturns, a couple of downturns, and maintained a really good friendship.
Good. Well, you know, I saw something with this hospice nurse, and she asked people what their largest regrets were in. Gosh, I wish I could remember them now. Oh, the first one was they regretted working so much. The second one was they regretted not keeping in touch with friends, you know, and there were two others. But I thought that friendship one was an interesting one, and I find the older you get, the more important those longtime friendships become. I mean, you know, we're making new friends all the time, and that's great. But it's wonderful to have a history, isn't it?
Right. Keep new friends and cherish the old.
So Joe, Big Joe didn't win Song of the Year that year.
No, he didn't. Yeah. But as people saw briefly from the video, he did get to play at the.
Great.
At the dinner, and he considered that a tremendous accolade in front of all of his peers, and did a great show, three numbers.
Well, you know, the Blues Foundation is a great organization. I went to their site and I looked at all the things they do, and you know, one sad thing is the Monterey Blues Festival in our area has gone away this year, and like that. But they did such a wonderful outreach in education too. They had a program called Blues in the Schools. Mm-hmm. Speaking of programs, now you're with Guitars Not Guns, and tell me a little bit about that.
Well, it's a program that originated in Washington, D.C., and I first learned about it when I first saw you on stage at a West End festival for a fundraiser for the White Album, or the White Ensemble.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that was a few years back.
Yeah, and that's how I first learned about Guitars Not Guns, and I just kind of tracked down Steve Vagnini, who is the chapter president or director.
Yeah.
And he said, well, we have a class going in Seaside. I started teaching there a couple of years ago, and I'm still doing it. Yeah. And
so is that a rewarding experience for you? Now, Guitars Not Guns, the vision or the vision statement for them is to put guitars in the hands of youth, primarily at-risk youth, give them an alternative to the other things that are going on the streets. But, you know, the one important thing that I gleaned from Guitars Not Guns is that it's actually a mentorship, and it's a mentorship in whatever you do. You know, I always say, you know, you live your life by example, whether it's intentional or unintentional. And Guitars Not Guns has got a great intention. It's about an 8-week course.
That's the idea, although, like, I'm a teacher, and so obviously curriculum has to change, so it depends on the needs of the students, and but there is a suggested curriculum. We've deviated a little bit from it. Mm-hmm. In how we approach it, but it takes 8 weeks, then we have a graduation ceremony, and the students get to keep the guitar they've been learning.
Ooh.
If they practice regularly, and we ask them to do that.
Now, do they learn tablature and whatnot, or chords, and do they follow, like, they come in and say, I want to play Stairway to Heaven, or is there, you know, we are going to start out with Twinkle Twinkle Little Star.
Not that song.
That's a Beethoven piece.
Not that song.
Yeah.
But they do learn.
That's by the accent.
They do learn tablature.
Was he deaf? Or was that Mozart? I don't know. Go ahead, Joe. I'm sorry.
They do learn tablature. We start them off with Happy Birthday and show them the tab for that. Then we teach them a couple of chords, C and G, and Jambalaya is the first song they learn.
Ah, I love that song.
And then we sort of are kicking around sometimes what the second song will be. Sometimes the students will bring in a song. They brought in something by the Red Hot Chili Peppers, mm-hmm. and it was about suicide, and we had to kind of veto working on that particular
number. Yeah, to say, keep your socks on.
Yeah. You know, one thing I should mention.
That's a visual joke.
One thing
Red Hot Chili Peppers. Go ahead. Go ahead, Joe.
Don't get me started. One thing I should mention is that some of the students have stayed with us for a while.
Cool.
You know, we've had a student that's been there before I started. I've been doing it for 2 years.
I can imagine it having such an effect on some of these kids that they go on to share and teach themselves.
Absolutely. And I've seen that. One little boy has a little friend, it's a little girlfriend, I wouldn't call it a girlfriend, but they're friends. He's been teaching her right along, and you know, it's fascinating to see.
Yeah, musicians are smart too, you know. music is a beautiful thing, isn't it? It's an international language, and it transcends, you know, differences of major import, and brings people to, an international language that can transcend the circumstances of life, you know. Mm-hmm. It's been used in religion, it's been used in labor and recreation and everything else.
Well, listen,
I know that Big Joe Williams was a mentor for Big Joe Shelton, and I know that you had your house worked on by a contractor that worked on Robert Zimmerman's house, and you got a photograph of Big Joe Williams and
Big Joe Shelton.
Hold it up right to that camera right there. Yeah, yeah. Maybe I'll even hold it up.
All right, there you go.
I can kind of explain. Yeah.
The fellow on the left is Big Joe Williams, who is a blues musician from Crawford, Mississippi, and he was Big Joe Shelton's mentor. This picture was taken by Big Joe Shelton in the green room at Mississippi State during the Rolling Thunder review. Big Joe Williams had asked Big Joe Shelton to go backstage with him. You can see he was a little older, he has a cane, and so Joe went back and sat down and stepped back and took that picture. No one else has it.
Yeah.
Joe's asked me not to distribute it, so I don't.